Before I select the second euro-dollar strategy, I will run the generator for pound-dollar and for euro-pound. And why I will do that, let me open the MetaTrader. In this portfolio, I want to trade these three pairs. Let me remove dollar-swiss. And I will share with you why I want to trade exactly euro-dollar, pound-dollar, and euro-pound. So instead of dollar yen, I will drop here euro pound. All right, let me find it. Here it is. The market watch is not moving today because it is Saturday. Okay, I will drop euro pound over the chart, and here it is. So when I have in my portfolio euro dollar, pound dollar, euro pound, what you may notice, I'm having equal exposure, right? And we have such a tab on MetaTrader that will help you later to see if you are putting too much risk on one asset. For example, if you're trading 10 robots on euro dollar, you are putting too much risk on that asset, right? If you're trading euro dollar, pound dollar, dollar yen, dollar swiss, you're putting too much risk on the dollar because it is in every single pair. But when I have euro dollar, pound dollar, and euro pound, I have each one two times. One time euro, second time euro. One time pound, second time pound. One time dollar, second time dollar. Okay, so that's a simple demonstration for a balanced portfolio of assets. And as well, I will have two strategies for each one. Two for euro dollar on M15, two for pound dollar on M15, and two for euro pound on M15. And if you want to have a bigger risk diversification, you can go for one strategy euro dollar on M15, the second one on M5 or on H1, and then one pound dollar on M15, the second one on a different time frame, and so on. But for the simplicity of this course, I will stick to two from each pairs to different strategies, right, for the M15 time frame. And before I select the second strategy from the repository for the euro pound, I will run two generators for the pound dollar and for the euro pound. But I will do that in a separate FSB, not in the same program, because this will make it slower. And the good thing with FSB Pro actually is the fact that you can have a few of them opened. Now, the first thing I have to do is to download data for pound dollar and euro pound. Let's see if I don't have it. Pound dollar is here and euro pound is here. I have it with the FSB demo data. So the only thing I will have to do is to edit the spread and the swap long and swap short. So let me show you how I do that quickly. I'll put MetaTrader on the side so it will be easier for me. I will right click and go to specifications. Let's see what are the swaps. So we have swap long, -5.64. Swap short is -1.84. As spread, I will leave it to 20 for all of them. And commission is zero with that broker. And for euro pound, I have to do the very same thing. Euro pound, here we go. I will right click and go to specification actually. There it is. And we have -7.33, and swap short is +0.07. Okay guys, so pretty much that's it. Now I have the proper historical data for the pound dollar and for the euro pound, and I will open a new strategy. Let me make it on a big window, and you see the template is saved. I will just switch to pound dollar, and you can see that here is the swap long and short, and there are the changes. And if I go through the strategy properties, you can see that it is set the way I want it. I will click on the generator and I will have the same in common and as well in settings. So I'll click on start and let me bring one more FSB Pro over here. I will make it on a full screen. I will go for a new strategy and I will select Euro Pound. Yep, the swap long and swap short were saved. And something you may have noticed with the other one as well that I'm running, this one over here, is the fact that I run it over 200,000 bars and this one I will run over 100,000 bars. Just for the purpose of this course, I want to show you the difference and let's see if we can notice some important things like how many strategies will be calculated, because as I said, when we have bigger number of bars the generator is slower, and when having a fewer number of bars it will be faster. Just going very quickly through the settings to see if everything is the way I want it to be. Absolutely, the acceptance criteria. Okay, here we go. I am on the generator and I will hit on start. So now these two generators will be working while I am selecting the next strategy for Eurodollar in the first FSB Pro. All right, so I open it as a separate program, but I'm running one generator here for the pound dollar, one generator here for the euro pound, and I have this one here where I'll be selecting another strategy for the euro dollar that I'll use in my portfolio.